Find the approximate value of root 25.3. So here first step is identify the function. Okay, so see here, root 25.3, root of some number, so that number we will suppose as x. So y equal to root x is our function. Okay, now here approximate value we should find. Since we know root 25 is 5, so 25 point, root of 25.3 means 5 point something should come. So answer also we know here, 5 point something should come. Now after identifying the function y equals to root x, we will write in increment form. Delta y represent increment in y, and delta x represent increment in x. Okay, now always remember x plus delta x value will be question value 25.3. okay, now out of this 25.3 you have to find x value and delta x value. So your x value should be that value for which you can find root easily. So that means 25 root we know, so we will suppose x as 25 and delta x will be 0.3. okay, therefore x plus delta x will give 25.3. okay, now see, root 25.3 we should find, that is equal to y plus delta y, that means y we should find and delta y. Okay, so here y is root x, since y is root x, derivative of y is 1 by 2 root x. Okay, so dy by dx when x is 25 is 1 by 10. Okay, and here root x means root 25, that is 5. So y value we got 5, dy by dx value we got 1 by 10. Now to find delta y. So delta y will be, delta y is equal to what? Dy by dx into delta x. This is the formula for delta y. Dy by dx we got 1 by 10. Delta x we got 0.3. So answer is 0.03. So these two value we should substitute here. Okay, so now after getting this, now root of 25.3 we know is what? This is root 25.3, isn't it? Y plus delta y, but y value is 5 and delta y is 0.03, so 5.03. see, root 25.3 we got as 5.03. So this is the approximate value of this root. Here also root of the some number. So first identify the function. So y equals to root x. Okay, then write in increment form y plus delta y, root x plus delta x. Now x plus delta x value is question 49.5. So x value we should find as such that we can find root easily. So 49 root we know, it is 7, so x value will be 49 and delta x value will be 0.5. okay, now after this we will find y. Y is equal to root x, that is root 49, which is 7. So dy by dx will be 1 by 2 root x. So 1 by 2 root 7, 49. So 1 by 2 into 7, that is 1 by 14. Okay, and we will find delta y also. Delta y is dy by dx into delta x. So dy by dx we got 1 by 14. Delta x is 0.5. okay, so we can write 5 by 140, or we can simplify this to get decimal. So 0.5 divided by 14. So from 14 we can cancel. So 5 won't go. Again put 0. It will become 50. Then 14 threes are 42 will go. 8 will remain. Then it will become 80, isn't it? So 14 fives. So 0.035 is the final answer. Now we will write this one. Now root 49.5 is y plus delta y, but y is what? 7. Delta y is 0.035. so 7.035 is answer. And we know root 49 is 7, so 49.5 means 7 point something should come. Next question is root 0.6. So here identify the function first. So root of the number. Okay. So y equal to root x. Now write in increment form. So root x plus delta x. Now find x plus delta x is 0.6 here. Okay. So x value we should find, for which root we can find easily. So nearest to 0.6 integer value is 1. Root 1 we can find easily. Okay. So delta x will be what? See, this we should remember. X plus delta x should be 0.6. Now x value we supposed as 1. So delta x value will be 0.4 minus. Then only see 1 minus 0.4, 0.6 we will get. Okay. Then y root x, so root 1 means 1, dy by dx means 1 by 2 root x, that is 2 root 1, that is 1 by 2, okay. And then we will find delta y, which is dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx is 1 by 2, delta x is minus 0.4, that will give minus 0.2. Then we will write this equation, root 0.6. This equation is what? Y plus delta y. Okay. So this we can write in decimal 0.5. So y value is 1 and delta y is minus 0.2. So 1 minus 0.2 is what? 0.8. So square root of 0.6 is 0.8. Question number 5, 0.999 power 1 by 10. So here function is 10th root of any number. Okay. That means x power 1 by 10. This is our function here. Now we'll write in increment form. So x plus delta x 1 by 10. Now x plus delta x will be question. Okay. Now we will find x value such that we can find 10th root easily. So nearest integer from 0.999 is 1, and 10th root of 1 we can find easily. So what will be delta x then? 1 minus 0.001, isn't it? Because 1 minus 0.001 will give 0.999. Now next step is y. Y is x power 1 by 10. X is 1, 1. So answer is 1. Dy by dx will be what? 1 by 10 x power minus 1 from the power. That is minus 9 by 10. Okay. So dy by dx will be at 1. X value 1 means 1 power anything will be 1 only. So answer is 1 by 10. Now delta y we will find, which is dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx we got 1 by 10. Delta x is 0.001. So this will be 0.001. Okay, now this term, x plus delta x power 1 by 10, that is 0.999 power 1 by 10 is equal to y plus delta y, isn't it? But y value is 1, delta y value is minus 0.001. So final answer will be 0.9999. Question number 6 is 15 power 1 by 4. So here first function is x power 1 by 4. Okay, this is the function here. We will write in increment form. So y plus delta y, x plus delta x power 1 by 4. Now x plus delta x value will be question value, which is 15. So from this we should get x value and delta x value. So your x value should be like this, such that you can find fourth root of that value easily. So we know nearest integer from 15, whose fourth root directly or easily we can find is 16, isn't it? Fourth root of 16 will be 2. Okay, so this we can find easily. So x value will be 16. Now delta x value will be minus 1, because 16 minus 1 means 15, isn't it? We have to add na, x plus delta x. So 16 plus this value minus 1, so 15. After this we will find y. Y is x power 1 by 4. X is 16 power 1 by 4, that is 2. Dy by dx will be 1 by 4 x power minus 3 by 4. Okay, x value is 16. So here 16 means 2 power 4 we can write. 4 4 will go. So 1 by 4 2 minus power minus 3 means power 1 by 2 cube, that is 1 by 8 we can write, that is 1 by 32. Now delta y is dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx is 1 by 32, delta x is minus 1, so minus 1 by 32. Okay, so now after this we should write, isn't it? So x plus delta x power 1 by 4, that is 15 power 1 by 4. Question is y plus delta y, but y is what, 2, and delta y is minus 32. Okay, so we can write 64 minus 1 by 32, so 63 by 32. So this we can simplify. 32 2s are 64, so 1 we should do, hai na? So if that, then number which will remain here will be here 8, 23, and 31 will remain here. Okay, again 31 won't go with 32, we should put 0 here, so 310. So check for the 9. Yes, so 9 will give 288. Okay, so again 22 will remain, that won't go, so we will check with 8, 30. So 32 sevens are 6, we have to check. Okay, so 32 6 198, so we have 220 and 198. Okay, so 22 will remain. So from 8 we can, so 1.968 you can write as final answer. 26 power 1 by 3, so y we will suppose here x power 1 by 3. So y plus delta y will be x plus delta x power 1 by 3. X plus delta x value will be question value, which is 26. So from this x value we should find and delta x. So x value will be, x value should be such that cube root of that number we can find easily. So near to 26, 27 is there, isn't it? Cube root of 27 is 3. So x value we should take 27. Then to get 26, delta x should be minus 1. Okay. Now y is x power 1 by 3. So 27 1 by 3, that is 3. Dy by dx is 1 by 3, x power minus 2 by 3. So 27 minus 2 by 3. So 3 cube we can write, 3 will go. So 1 by 3 into 3 is square means 9. So 1 by 27 we will get here. Delta y is dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx is 1 by 27, delta x is minus 1. So minus 1 by 27. Now we will write this value. 26 power 1 by cube is y plus delta y, but y is 3 and delta y is minus 1 by 27. Okay, so from 27 we can multiply this. Minus 1 by 27, that is 80 by 27. So from 27, 3 is 81, hai na? But 80 is there, that means it will go with 2. 27, 2 is 54, so 80 by 54 means 26 will remain. So 26 will put 0 here, so it will go with 9 then. 27, 9 is 243, yes. So then here 17 will remain. Okay, so 170. So check with 6 then. Yes, 162. So 6. So now 8 will remain. So 80, it will become 80. Again 80, that means it will go with 2. Okay, then again 26 will remain, so 9. So 2.9629 we can write as the final answer. Power 1 by 2. So let y is what? X power half. This is our function. Write in increment form. So x plus delta x power 1 by 2. So x plus delta x value is question value, that is 401. X value will be, see, we should select one nearest number to 401 such that root we can find easily. So we know root of 400 is 20. So 400 we will take. Then delta x will be plus 1. Then only 400 plus 1 will give 401. Now y we should write root x or x power half only. So 400 power half means 20. Dy by dx will be 1 by 2 root x. Okay, so 400 means 1 by 20, that is 40. Now delta y we will find. So dy by dx 1 by 40 into 1. So delta y is 1 by 40 here. Here only we can simplify this. Okay, so 1 by 4 1/4 into 1/10 we can write 1/4 means 0.25. So 1/10 means 0.025. Now this value we should write, isn't it? So 401 power half is y plus delta y. But y we got 20, delta y we got 0.025. So answer will be 20.025. 0.0037 power half. So function is x power half, y equal to x power half. Increment form will be y plus delta y, x plus delta x power half. Okay, now x plus delta x value is question value 0.0037. So x value should be that value for which root we can find easily. So we know 0.37, no? So 0.0036, isn't it? For this answer will be, root will be 0.06. So x we should consider 0.0036. So what will be delta x then? 0.0001, isn't it? If we add in this, we will get 0.0037. So now next step is, since y is root x, so root of 0.0036 means 0.06. dy by dx is 1/2 root x. So root x we know 0.06. So 0.12. Okay, then delta y. So this is 1/0.12. Delta x is 0.0001, or we can shift the decimal here, so 0.0001 only divide by 12. Okay, now from 12 we can cancel that one, so, or better leave here. Now see this, we should substitute here. So 0.0037 power half is y plus delta y, but y is what? 0.06. delta y is 0.01/12. okay, so from this we can multiply. So this will give 0.73. okay, so from 12 we can cancel this. 12 ones are, see this 7 won't go, then put 0 here, then 73 we can take, so 6 are, then 1 will remain, so we'll put 0, it will become 10. 10 won't go, so put 0, it will become 100. So 12 8s are 96, 4 will remain, so 12 3s are we can write, so answer is 0.06083.